I am going to have a different tone from my very good friend.
Je vais adopter un autre
ministre Gadio
que celui de mon
I'm
excellent ami
afro-optimiste.
Monsieur Gadio,
so
parce
I'm
que je suis
starting
afro-optimiste.
By saying
je
that
vais donc commencer par dire
many good news come
ou vous
from the
part
continent.
D'un grand nombre de
according
bonnes nouvelles,
to the IMF, Sub-Saharan Africa is now the second fastest growing region in the world, trailing only Asia. As per Emerging Market Private Equity Association latest survey of institutional investors, Sub-Saharan Africa is poised to see the greatest increase in
the
new private equity commitment across the emerging markets over the years,
dans les
the coming years,
aging
out
privé
Brazil,
à travers
China,
les marchés
India
émergents,
as the most attractive destination
Brésil,
for deals.
La Chine et l'Inde,
third
en
good
étant,
news, according to the Africa Development Bank,
de
one third of the continent is considered
BAT,
middle class, spending between $4 and $20 a day. By 2060, more than
a
billion Africans are expected to join them.
Plus d'un milliard d'Africains
the African middle class
cette équation.
Is mostly urban.
La classe
Africa
en
urbanization rate
est
is already 37%
urbaine,
compared
le
to China
taux d'urbanisation
and larger than India. Africa will be
comparable
the fastest
Chine,
urbanized
plus élevé
region
qu'en
from
l'Afrique
2020 to 2050. Stability,
une,
my good friend talked about the issue we are having.
Entre 2020
we acknowledge
2050.
It, but stability made significant progress since the end of the Cold War. Since then, the number of armed conflicts has fallen from more than 30 to about a dozen, the one you cited, even though violence is still a reality, as we say, in South Sudan, some part of the Democratic Republic of the Congo or Somalia. Yet, democratic elections are now becoming the norm. We still have some challenges. I was observing the election in Kenya. But good news are also coming out from Senegal, our great country, Ghana, Verde, Mali, Guinée,
Sénégal,
and
Ghana,
even Gambia.
Cap Vert,
so
Mali, Angoulé,
I think also democracy
Gambie,
is making
si
much progress.
Reste à faire dans des pays comme
we do believe that we have to make African resources work for the African people. Africa is estimated to contain 80% of the entire world supplies of platinum and cobalt, half of the world gold supplies, two-thirds of the world manganese, 35% of the world uranium, 75% of cobalt, important mineral for electronic devices. Africa has, it was said by the Minister of Morocco, around
100
million hectares.
Et 35%
so the future of mankind nutrition might be in our hands.
Aussi
post-independent born African leaders want to do business differently with the rest of the world. And the BRICS are good news for us, as monopoly, as you know, is not good for business, and it has not been necessarily good for us.
Les
as a good news, and who doesn't want to hear that? We are young. Africa has the fastest growing and most useful population in the world. Over 40% are under the age of 15 to 20.
Parce que nous avons
and we do have 200 million youth in Africa. Of course, it comes with challenges, and I think the minister talked about some of them.
De
but we also have to know that a larger population means a larger working
mais
population,
sûr,
means more disposable income, as
active,
more people are able to work the family
revenus,
and leads to improvement of living standards.
De plus en plus
and a large workforce now
et
and
coup,
in the future also means more taxpayers, so more money
vie,
and more funding for
que
government. Yet we agree, and I'll talk about it very quickly, this requires very specific investment from African government. We need to tackle our challenges with our historical resilience.
And
we know that. I don't think that never on earth any people have been going through hardship as African. Yet we are here and resilient. Economic growth has been not inclusive enough. We agree. And despite a growing middle class, one third of Africans, way too many Africans still live in absolute poverty. What we need to do
croissance galopante,
is to develop a continent-wide social safety net program to ensure universal access to health,
to education, water, electricity, and decent housing for the African people,
including those living in rural areas and who are often left out. What I'm talking about is a social African compact
to speak.
The growth has been associated with increased exploitation of non-renewable natural resources with heavy impact on the soil, water and forest. We then need to learn from ongoing greening industrialization experience over the world. The African economy are still largely based on raw material extraction with little to no value in terms of employment creation. So this is also something we really need to look at. But yet, Africa is seeing its diaspora coming back, mostly highly educated young Africans, movers and shakers, venturing in technology, supply chain, energy, especially in the solar and the bioenergy. Africa leads the world in mobile adoption, I think it was said yesterday,
and we do see opportunities,
cross-sectoral business opportunities, like mobile banking, virtual education system, etc. Africa services, the services sector, hold tremendous economic promises. In fact, growth in services has been twice than the average rate for the world during the period 2009 to 2012.
Les divers secteurs de services
we do have also to improve, it was said, good governance and to be further accountable to the African people.
This entails actively fighting corruption with legal framework and effective institutional anti-corruption bodies.
And I have to say for that also we need to cooperate with the West, with Europe, with Africa, with America, because usually when the money leaves our national budget, they find their way very much into the Western bank. We also need to further fight impunity and human rights violations. We need to strengthen the rule of law, and we need to improve, and it's very important to insist on that, the participation of youth,
because we have a huge bulk
of youth, the youth population, women, I talked about it yesterday, and let me tell you that they produce 70% of the food in the continent. So there's no way you want to make headways and progress in the agricultural sector if you don't take into consideration their needs and rights. And we also have to address the minorities.
We have to deal with diversity. What we would like to see
from the rest of the world as Africans,
and I'm saying it very nicely,
we need a better understanding of the rapidly changing reality in Africa. Africa is moving day by day, with less cliché, with no patronizing, because we also know that some of the attitudes that are just attitudinal are inherited from the colonial past. So that we have to be conscious of that and fight it, because Africa is changing.
There
are new and younger African leaders who are very grounded in their own culture, but yet fully conversant with international standards and the international cultures, and a new generation of very educated young Africans who looked at the world through different lenses than their parents.
That is maybe what China understands
better than many of its competitors in the country. Because they've been colonized, they've been oppressed,
so they have more empathy
and they understand maybe more quickly how we may feel. So that is something also our good friend from the Western world need to understand. We also need different business patterns. That's what we expect from our foreign partners with the slogan, fair must be fair.
And we do know that in all the deals that we try to make happen,
we are paying much higher.
Because
of insecurity, it is said, even though a country like Senegal is a very peaceful one and very having gone through different processes peacefully,
it happened that
our loans come most of the time more expensive than any other country.
Des fois, because of the, because Africa has, I believe, the worst public relationship strategy. Donc,
when we talk about Africa, you move from HIV public, and then lately from Ebola, but in between, there are so many grateful things that happen in this country. If you have seen yesterday, for those who were at the reception, this young lady from Mali, that energy that you saw, that is also what we are feeling and seeing every day.
Donc
in
c'est
the
ce qu'on voit
we also
chaque jour,
need to build
au jour
le jour solidarity
sur le continent africain. Il s'agit pour nous de travailler sur la solidarité et essayer de lutter
said,
contre le terrorisme, contre la corruption, comme vous l'avez dit, cher ami.
Donc,
l'immigration clandestine, les impacts du changement climatique et la solidarité pour partager les problèmes. Je vous remercie de votre présence.